listeners, I'm happy to have you again on this channel. Those who are listening, those who are watching, thank you so much for following. And we are always happy that you always don't forget to follow our YouTube channel, yeah. Following our Spotify.
Yeah.
So that you can enjoy our music at the same time, enjoy our stories.
Yeah, you're fond of good work.
Yeah. So today I'm here with my colleague.
Yeah, Matt of Edrin,
uh-huh.
And I'm also Ugandan, but at the moment I live here in Germany. I think this is the second time you have invited me to this kind of interview.
So I think the and third time, my friend.
The fourth time, okay.
Yeah, it's almost the fourth time.
Time is flying.
So, as I said, that on this channel we shall be sharing our experiences and also what we are doing as African people, all the Ugandans who are living in Europe, in Germany more especially, where we tell our own stories, but also to inspire ourselves, but also to inspire the people who are out there looking at doing what we are doing. So today, people will ask me on this channel, want to know more about Edrin Matov. What does he do? So, my friend, Edrin Matov, you are a performing artist.
Yeah, I am.
So tell me, how did you start doing performing art?
Yeah, that's a good
question. When did you start doing performing art?
Yeah, after really some years back. Mm-hmm. I think being a professional, kind of doing it as a professional match.
Mm-hmm.
I think that was my, after my P7, primary 7.
Yeah, that's like you're saying, Grundschule or the primary level.
After Grundschule,
mm-hmm.
in German classes, but of course in Uganda, after the primary level,
mm-hmm.
that's when I joined a certain performing organization in Uganda,
mm-hmm.
and we used to do a lot of drumming, mm-hmm. of course, more of like cultural dances, traditional dances, folk mm-hmm. music, instrumentation, and all those things.
Mm-hmm.
So I was doing it parallel with education. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. At what age was that? When did you start doing that in your primary? At what age?
Because I remember finishing primary, I think when I was 13, then I think around 14 there. But I'm
around 14, So 14, it means you started to identify your talent at a very tender age, 14.
I can't say I discovered my talent, maybe my elder sister with the family just recognized that I can do this. And then I joined the organization. So I was doing it, by that time I was more focused on football.
On football, but...
Yeah, but of course, doing it with music and traditional dance, and living and performing ensemble, so it was more doing more rehearsals and trainings.
More rehearsals and training. So exactly, yes. Were you an all-rounder for all performing arts, or did you specialize on any kind of performing art?
At the moment, that performing ensemble, it was more focused more on the traditional music and traditional dances.
Mm.
So we used to do drumming, of course, different dances in Uganda, traditional dances of Uganda, Baxi, Bachitan. Yeah, so it was more focused on traditional things.
More traditional African dances.
African dances.
Super.
Focus, yeah.
Wow, you know what?
Mm.
I tried that too, but I couldn't reach far.
What happened?
I was always told, Otako, thank you so much. You are good at this. But could you maybe be the one clapping? So I was always the one clapping. And other people were dancing and drumming.
Yeah. But that's everyone is having a role. So your role was always doing also.
It was
really
good.
Great. Yeah.
To clap.
It's part of the choreography and performing in traditional dance.
Yes. Thank you for that. At least I know that I was playing a very big role in my... In my water. So I want to know, when did you start, like, you do music and also you're talking about dance. So of the two, what do you prefer as a person?
It depends, because dancing, I think I started dancing when I was really, really young, dancing much, because I remember the time when my mom used to make us as young kids to entertain the visitors at home. And she used to like dancing a lot and singing. So we could get that time, and then she put some... By that time, it was this kind of music, Lingala, remember Lingala?
Music from Congo.
Dombolo, music from Congo.
Wow.
Dombolo, it was everyone Dombolo. So we used to learn shaking.
And
you could get small prizes, the best dancer, some soda, Coca-Cola, we'll go to town with you. So that's small prizes from
small prizes.
So it was more dancing before. Then the singing part, it wasn't much in me. And I think I discovered that so later that I could also sing.
Okay.
But yeah, more dancing before, yeah.
So, which kind of music really? Since you started in like music, I've heard your music. Actually, I like your music. I really like your music.
Thank you
I
so
listen to your
much.
music in yeah. So I calm down when I'm like there was the stress of learning the German language. I calm down with your music.
Thank
It
you,
was the stress of
brother.
working 8 hours a day and come back. I play your music and I listen to it
I
over the
know.
weekend and I really
Thank
feel
you.
happy.
Thank you
Yeah,
so
to
much.
do.
It's really
Yeah.
honest.
So which kind of music do you really, which kind of music do you play? I mean, I would like to know. Maybe also other people out there would like to know what kind of music does Adrian Matovu plays.
Yeah, at the moment, I don't want to put my music more in the structured like R&B or jazz or
Okay.
something or hip hop. But all my music right now I'm doing, the recording music, it's more in the genre of like getting more influence from the background of our traditional music. So I would like to, I'm doing much of integrating our traditional instrumentation, our traditional feeling of music to put it in the kind of a contemporary feeling of music. So some people they can call it world music or Afro soul, but of course my music is most of the time so calming and in the aspect also of changing environment. It's not more of a danceable one. Some people also think, Edwin, your music is so sad and you're so calm. It's like you're so sad. Are you sad? But the inspiration is more from being calm and want more to play educative music, but of course with more influence with my background of the traditional music I'm like, so it's like integrating to make it in the
To fuse a
contemporary.
fusion of
It's like
traditional
and
Afro
yeah,
tradition
Afro traditional. It's like
that's
more
wonderful.
Afro, like kind of a
Not
contemporary
contemporary.
music. So find traditional to put it in contemporary aspect.
That's nice. For I really feel I think music not all about dancing. Music plays a very different role around the world. So to me, I feel like I would like sometimes to calm down, and that's why I like your music. Sometimes when I need to jump around and dance, and I play some danceable African
Yeah,
music.
a lot of
Yeah,
danceable music
and
Africans,
sometimes
yeah.
if I don't want to dance, I just want to jump. I play some German music that I may
Yeah.
not able to follow the dancing, but I just jump around.
Yeah, music
Yeah,
is
your
music, yeah.
music is music. Music is a healing to me.
Yeah,
And thank
me
you for
too.
your work as a musician.
Thank
So,
you.
another thing, so I because you also dance, you still do dance.
I still do dance. Dancing's in me, yeah.
Which kind of dances do you do?
Basically, from the background, I have traditional dances of Uganda. That one I do it. And I do what most of people call African contemporary dances, so it's more roots of the traditional dances, but put it in the contemporary context. So in this kind of thing, I really prefer that more right now, not
That's
more
contemporary.
the contemporary bringing contemporary what is now, but using more things, more traditional movements,
Oh, traditional
but to
movements.
introduce what is happening right now. So not to stay more, I don't want to call it conservative, like to say traditional dance, but I borrow most of the dances, but to put, like get a theme, let's say like climate change, then I borrow, well, of course, the dance vocabulary, movement vocabulary is based from our traditional dances from Uganda, and then I can make a dance piece out of it. So it's more like contemporary, but more based with a lot of strong background from our traditional
So,
dances.
since now you're living in Europe, do you define yourself as doing more dance that is Ugandan dance, or do you describe it as African dance to generalize it? Or do you also have other movements that are African dance movements that you know from other African countries that you integrate within your dance, contemporary dance?
That's a good question, but to put like African dance, but most of people of course call it African dance because you come from Africa, but it's not like Africa because I have never been to Senegal, I've never been to Nigeria or other Western countries. So basically, I want to call it a Ugandan traditional dance because that one I know and I have rights. I really know what I'm talking about. But since I'm coming from also Uganda is from Africa. So, I mean, it's okay also when people call it African dance or something like that.
Good. Yeah.
So,
So I as in you're a dancer, and if it is it's you the person, if someone says, "Oh, he's going for us African dance," and you're like, "No, I'm not doing for you guys African dance. Yeah. I'm doing Ugandan dance.
Yeah, sometimes you need to be specific, especially to students, because they might get confused.
Mm.
They might think, because I work in a school, and some students think like Africa is like German, it's like a country.
So, yeah.
So we need you have to teach them to define it, that this dance, it is from it's from Uganda, but also it's from this part of Uganda.
Mm.
Not like all Ugandans you meet, they will know about this dance. So you have to be specific as a teacher too.
That's where it brings me. You see, you guys, me, I'm not a dancer. I'm telling you this. I don't know how to dance.
Everyone is a dancer.
Everyone is a dancer because the moves, everyone is a dancer. Just like the way I say, everyone is a storyteller.
You know?
Because they can tell something, So anyway, I like it that most times they address me like, yeah, Otako, you have some good African dance movements.
Yeah.
But do you know my experience of doing dancing in Uganda? I tried dancing in Uganda.
In school. Traditional
dance and that.
Then
they pushed me to the people who are clapping. So I couldn't dance. They said, Otako, you are good. You can move. You can do everything. But I think you are good when you clap, or maybe.
But of course.
But when I came to Europe, I did some movements and we're in a club and people stopped dancing and they looked at me. I said, "This guy is an African dancer. Look at the movements." One day I was doing a theater play. In France. Of course, I had pain on my leg, so when I was walking on stage, I was limping. Literally limping. But after the show, there's some white old person who said, "I like the African dance movement in this play." I was the only African person in that play.
Yeah, so the African moves are really great.
I said in my head,
"Yeah,
I was limping, really." What?
But it was dancing. Even limping is dancing.
With pain?
Yeah, you never know, you were dancing.
Anyway, if you are Ugandan and African and you're in Europe, don't miss that stereotype. You'll enjoy it.
So you say,
literally, I was limping. But I now become a dancer now. I'll try to become one.
You were a dancer already.
Anyway, so.
Yeah.
So what inspires you to start singing?
That's really very good question, Otako.
Mm-mm.
Thank you so much for that question.
Mm.
Before I left Uganda, I wasn't really doing much of singing. Mm. I was really dance and I was teaching dance in that aspect. But when I came here, by the time of this lockdown, of course, this situation of COVID lockdown, and I had a lot of hope here in Germany to do more dance workshops, as I used to do it before in different schools, different communities. Then the lockdown came.
Okay.
And I couldn't move anywhere. I would only stationed in my home. I could stay in my room alone.
Yeah.
So, and in me, I had something which feels like I need to share something. I had that urge, like, Edwin, you need to share something this time.
Yeah.
You need to bring something out. And the good thing, there was a traditional instrument.
Yeah.
We came with, I think, I got it even from my brother. It's called Peter Kato. Thank you so much. There's this traditional instrument. He gave it to me. Because I visited him and he was like, Edwin, you can take it.
Yeah.
It's called Adungu.
Adungu.
With strings. I play it with strings.
Adungu. I think I put it here on the screen. You see Adungu. This guy is.
Yeah. So when I visited my brother there and he gave it to me, I said, Edwin, you can use this Adungu.
Mm.
I took it. And then in this lockdown, I was home and then I started playing it, singing our traditional music as I used to do it in Uganda. Mm. Then I had something in my head, but Edwin, you can even go beyond. You can use this instrument also to start thinking about maybe recording your music. And I started slowly by getting some words of different situations.
Mm.
And I remember very much many things were happening in Uganda, elections, all that drama.
COVID and that.
And the first song was inspired by that. And I haven't released that song. It's called Baluganda. Will come very soon.
Baluganda. Okay, super. I look forward to that song.
Yeah, you hear
it. You know, guys, Baluganda means like...
Yeah.
In English, how do you say?
Like we are brothers.
Brothers, sisters, it's a blood, like, you know.
Yeah.
Ubuntu, you are one.
Yeah,
we are all together. We are all humans.
The title of the song. Mm-hmm. So the situation was really so hard in Uganda, what's happening. A lot of drama, a lot of politics, a lot of things.
Mm.
And at the end of the day, I was asking myself, but why are we all fighting so much for all the thing? And we are all brothers. Mm-hmm. We at the same time, you fight for this. But at the end of the day, it's me or Taco you give me. At the same time, I'm the one who's going to provide for you when something happens. So I went into my head as I have to challenge myself with the thing. While I was doing it, I was with my girlfriend, and my girlfriend saw the passion because I was playing watch a lot at home because I couldn't really dance alone so much.
Yeah.
And on Christmas, I got the surprise gift of a mic.
Microphone,
yeah. A big microphone on Christmas. I was like, what? I have to do this now. This is my time. I have to start recording my music. So
the inspiration that was you are doing with your microphone.
And the microphone coming just in the process when you're trying to, but in the head, I said, how are you going to start to record? And all of a sudden, friends and the mic is there. They have given you a gift like a microphone.
Yeah, wow.
With a crossover. Then I said, okay, this time, Adrian, I have to. I cannot disappoint people who have gifted me this. I have to find a way of using it, utilizing it.
The
gift. So when I came to Castle here, I think it was in January this year. It's not that much. January this year, and then I started slowly with the situation in Uganda. Then I recorded the first song. And when I recorded it, it was like a trial. It was more first try with the traditional song. And it worked out. Even I think Onyango came by that time of Onyango. And also we did also with Noah some traditional singing. So all that, like, it was down, like latent, and started developing inside. Edwin, you can still do this. Because I remember even posting one of our traditional songs we did with Onyango and Noah.
Yeah, guys, Onyango and Noah, these are friends of Edwin Matovu. So they all like to use music as a healing.
Yeah.
Yo.
So when we did that thing, we put it on social media, and you also listen to it, and we're like, we like this music. This music is so nice.
Yeah.
It's helping, it's healing, it's really good. So I got empowered, I get that motivation. Yeah, we have to do more, maybe. And then something which came into my head when I started looking, I was like, Edwin, you don't have copyright for these songs. You might do use these songs, but these are traditional songs. Yes, you own it because you come from that thing, but these are not your songs. And the thing of like education as you study here, is this something you say as an artist you can still create?
Yeah.
There's room for you to create.
Yeah, and do yeah.
So then I started, of course, with Baluganda, many songs. Then in my head I said, okay, I can do the album. My first song, people who listen to it around were like, this is old, this is smooth, this is good.
So to cut the story short, so you already in the process of doing your album.
Yeah, I'm reading. So far, I have like 14 songs.
Wow.
I'm just doing the mastering. So far, I have 14 songs.
Edwin has 14 songs, and they are doing them the mastering. That's the technical one.
Yeah, that's the more technical. Listening to the sound, to the balance, the compressing. How is it the instrument sound? You want it on the left, you want it on the right, on the middle, how would the sound come out? So it's more technical, but more creative work. It is done for those 14 songs, so it's more mastering.
So it's really, I like your story of being inspired to really do the music that you just found yourself.
Yeah.
Coronavirus happening, you cannot meet people, and at the end of the day, you realize you have the adungu, and you start playing the adungu, and by playing this adungu, that instrument from Uganda, then you realize you can sing, and then someone gives you a gift of a microphone, and then you are there already, starting to do an album.
I'm hoping, because I've opened different so music platforms where people can find my music.
We shall be there.
Okay.
Where people will find your music and then we continue. So anyway, guys, by the way, if you have not liked this YouTube channel, Otako, subscribe.
Yeah.
And also, if you have not followed Edwin Matovu on his platforms, he has a YouTube channel.
Yeah.
This YouTube channel of Edwin Matovu, if you have not.
Yeah.
What is the YouTube channel, please?
Yeah, the name of YouTube channel is Edwin Matovu Arts. Like Arts.
So guys, don't forget to subscribe to Edwin Matovu Arts.
Yeah,
Edwin Matovu on his YouTube channel.
YouTube channel,
and that would be really great to support his music, and also to to follow up to know which new song is coming and when the album is coming
out. When the album is coming out.
So good.
Yeah.
Yes. So, I would like also to just know something. So, you live right now in Germany? Is music being your real job? Are you doing music as a job?
I can't say that. Music is like kind of my space where I feel free to share with my people I can't reach because of coronavirus and everything. It's like, it's not my permanent job because I'm working at the school. I'm doing my practicals as a teacher in a Waldorf school. So I think professional, I'm like being a teacher. But music,
you're a teacher of what?
I'm a teacher of music, but also a class teacher. So also I started Waldorf Education.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, when I came to Germany.
Where do you specialize?
I specialize in being a class teacher
and
also music teacher.
So like, a class teacher.
Class teacher, according to the Waldorf pedagogy, that's another story. But it's from a person, a teacher who gets from the first class, the first class to the eighth class. In the Waldorf system. Yeah.
Guys, as I promised you one time, I'll get Edwin Matovu, who will talk about the Waldorf system how education and how he's doing there, how he made it to get a master's in this education.
Kind of education.
And then you'll be informed, those who are really interested and you're musicians and you want to take your music here in Europe, but also to study.
Yeah.
Don't forget to subscribe and follow.
Yeah.
We shall give them more on that. Yeah. So you are literally a teacher.
Yeah, literally a teacher.
And you do music as a passion.
Yeah, music is not my passion, but my focus, most of the focus is like a space.
Space.
I create my space where I share with my people and all. Because what I'm really singing in this song is not more fun, it's like more sharing what I know,
what you know,
and what I think is needs to be changed somehow. Where so it's like more space for me to share with my people.
More space. In simple words, that you create a space where you your own healing, sharing,
ideas,
and telling your own stories.
Yeah, telling my stories. Thank you for putting
telling your own stories
thank
through
you so
music.
Much. Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
It's that's really defined well for me. I understand it, and I hope the viewers and the listeners have really understood that.
I'm sure. I'm sure.
So anyway, you see, every musician in their life when they're starting, or any person when they're doing their passion for musical art or performing arts, they have an audience they look at. So which is your target audience? Which people do you want to listen to this kind of music that you're doing?
First of all, my music is more, I do much of the Luganda, my mother expression, that's my mother language, Luganda and English most of the time, and a little bit of some music, I try to put some lines of German. Of course, I'm not that good, I try to put some German text also in between there.
Yeah, Edwin speaks German.
No,
I'm able to understand him because I'm learning German. But most times, you know, we are here in German, Edwin speaks to German people, German, and they understand him. So I think you're my brother.
Yeah, I'm trying. I'm learning. I'm the process. That's what I can say.
Yeah.
But my audience is, I think my music will go to the old people who can really understand what I'm saying. There are many people, you know, music, as we say, it's a universal language. Many people can take the text and they hear the text, what the message of the song. And other people can be healed with the melody and, you know, some kind of thing. I think it's more universal, but needs really, my music is so calm. It's like not more danceable. It's really hard for people to take it in the club.
I danced your music.
To put it in the club.
I just danced to your song. That mean me.
No. In this kind, I get you. I also dance to my song, but different kind of dancing. Not this more charming, jumping. It's like dance hall. It's not like in the club when people are really drinking their thing and you put music to go. So it's not like more hyping.
It's more of like you hear the music and then you shake your head here.
It's a music
that allows you to some movement.
Yeah, to calm down and to think and to reflect about life and to reflect what you do. So it's more of an educative text about nature. So I think every person in life, that's why I can't say I'm categorizing my audience here, because I think in a certain kind of life, certain point of life, there is time when you feel like you want to calm down, you want to reflect yourself.
Most of the times, people enjoy music and Some of them think they can sing, like me. I only sing in the bathroom when I'm alone in the bathroom.
Yeah.
When I'm pure, I'm sure that there's no one at home. That's when I start singing.
Yeah.
That's where I can feel the energy of singing.
Yeah.
So I don't know. When I'm on stage, of course, I try to sing. Yeah. But of course, I tell them, yes, I'm going to sing, but I'm not good at singing.
Yeah.
You think I can sing?
I think everyone can sing. You know, the thing of like talent and you don't have a talent or you can't do this because you don't have a talent. Most of people who have been really successful in different aspects, footballers, singers, dancers, most of people who are really successful in the kind of like a talent thing, they are really not there. But because of practice and the love and the passion and the commitment they put into that kind of activity they want to do, they really prosper. So, because me personally, people who I grew up, they know me as a dancer. So I think most of them are even really like kind of surprises. Edwin, they're really dancing or singing.
Oh.
We knew him as a dancer. So
I can surprise people who know me as
a storyteller.
Or as an actor, or as a comedian, and I start just singing.
Yeah, when you get your passion and you get committed to it and you train, of course you can.
I should stop singing and dancing in the bathroom so that I bring the two to the public.
you have all the powers. It's like one of my songs I'm going to release very soon. It's like we have all the powers to present what we have on this earth. So it's you using your hand and your passion to bring it out. So if you have passion and love for it, everything
is possible. Guys, if you have passion, love for anything you want to do in life, everything is possible.
Yeah.
It is up to you to decide the fate of your talent or
what you can do.
So my brother, is there anyone in your family or your relatives that is doing music that inspired you, or did you get something just like from nowhere?
Yeah, what I know about my family, especially on the side of my mom, I think I saw a lot of talent there, but not in the aspect of being a professional dancer or more professional singers in that aspect. But of course, my elder brother, they used to dance. Also, my brother is a dance teacher at the university, and also my older sister was dancing. So dancing is, I can say we got it from our mom, because our mom used to really
put music.
Like music and dancing. For that one, I remember as a kid, my mom used to really like dancing, and he was really good. So I think we got that much, I got much talent of art in that aspect from the side of my mom.
Simple message from my brother. Parents, put things at home for your kids so they can easily feel them, and thus you can support them to develop something that they have within themselves. If they, you know, you like reading and you want to see them read, put the books near them. You want them to play the drums, put the drums next to them. You want them to play the pianos, put things that they can play with as toys at that. If you want them to dance, put the danceable music and they dance.
Yeah.
If you want them to sleep, make sure there's a bed always for them to sleep. Anyway, so tell me, what would you say to, mainly this question goes to anyone who's, for example, an African, Ugandan person, or any person from Africa or whichever country, and traveled to, decided to move to Europe, or maybe to live like in Germany, decided to come to Germany, and they still do their art, and they would like to continue with art. It's really hard. Most of us, we come here with our talent and we lose it. What message would you say to these people? What advice would you like to share with them?
I think one of the hardest thing here when you come, there's a lot of things which changes. The way we do things and the environment and everything like that, it changes. So it's you, I think, to go back to get to know what you want really to do. Because when you come here, of course, they have a lot of program and everything is on time. And you have to study the language. So there's a lot of kind of losing of concentration, a lot of stress, you know, my brother, paperwork, run there, this physician room, they are calling you, the visa is running, school and everything. So you find of yourself, you are lost somewhere. But I think something which I can tell, I can witness me as a person, when I got to know that, of course, I am here, I'm doing house building, or I'm doing master, I'm studying, There's, of course, that time you create for Germans. Most of them, they go for Wanderung or just walking around Spazierengehen.
Yeah.
Yeah, walks. So, and there's something I learned from them. Like they get, even students, they get that time to learn instruments.
Mm.
Because most of the students, so kids here play different piano, yes, guitar, violin. So, also, if you like have an artist from Uganda and you're here, you have to, so when you still have passion, to create a room for yourself, because for yourself to do what you want, but no one is going to create it for you. But you find a way of, when I'm home, when I'm done with stress, stress is there, but it will not go there in one day. Create your space where you can practice your art. And the good thing now, the social media is here, so you don't need to engage many people.
Yeah.
So if you like, you have your story for your storyteller, you can put your phone there.
And you do front, it.
And you do it and you share with people around. Many people at home, everywhere, they will see. If you're a dancer, you can still put your phone there and you dance and you put it out. So it goes back to you creating time for what you love. Because when you don't create time for what you love, of course, you'll be in depression. And of course, no one's going to provide that space for you. It's only you who can provide the space for you to do something which will bring you down and something which have passion in it.
So guys, as you have heard Edwin say, you need to create your time so that you can do something that you love.
Yeah.
And you know, when you love it, that means that you can do it.
Yeah,
that's what I learned.
Yeah.
When I know what I'm telling is really funny and I'm laughing towards it, that means that the person watching is also going to laugh because they can really understand why I'm laughing.
It's organic, you know.
It's organic.
Something natural. It's not like artificial.
Yeah, it's not like artificial. So
yeah.
Anyway, guys, so since Matov said that I can also sing, I want to challenge myself whether you first sing or I first sing.
No, it's okay. We can try. We can try this. I think you know this tradition song. It's more with, like, we used to sing it when you're so young. Like, Sisi. You remember that song of Sisi?
I like that song. I like that song. It's a Ugandan traditional song. Traditional song?
Yeah, it's a traditional song. It's a folk song.
It's a folk song.
It comes from a story because it has a story.
It has a story behind it.
Yeah,
in simple words, can you summarize what the story is about so that someone who doesn't understand the language, they can know what story it's about?
Yeah, Sisi, it's a song which really focuses, like, they are like kids. They're like two kids or three kids who went in the forest. And Sisi, Twagena Mchibina. I'm still to recall it. So it's like a story. By that time, it was more educative because by our those times, education was more from storytelling from our grands. So they used like to warn kids from eating from neighbors whenever they go to walk around alone in the forest, to be alone and to eat around. Dangers will come to them. So this story is like these two kids, they went in the forest and they're like collecting bananas or fruits in the forest. And as they are collecting it, they saw a big, like, kind of chimpanzee or something, like a beast in the forest. And they are really so scared.
A monster
coming, and they are like starting crying. See, dragon, like narrating. This is like narrating
what happened. Yeah. To them.
And but the beast in the song, the beast really reacted like kind of so kind, and it was for it. It was replying that no worries, young kids. For me, I don't harm young kids. Nothing I do to young kids. Whatever happens, I can do it to old people who are really guilty. They have a lot of bad things they are doing. But for your kids, you're so innocent. So please don't cry.
Don't cry.
Yeah, don't cry.
So we give it to the audience, guys.
Yeah, I can.
I am challenging myself as Otako.
Yeah.
Because they told me if I love it, I can do it.
Yeah. And you're really in love now.
Yeah, I want to do it.
Yeah, we can try. I can take it one more time, and then the second time you join.
Okay.
So we can take it. Sisi twagena mu kibira okunoga ebibala twali tubinoga ne tulengere sajja o mama lyali ddene nnyo ng'atenga gwanvu ne litugoba emisinde ne tukaba n'amaziga Mwesirikira bana sija kubalya nja kulya balya bakulu abagera ne mugga sisi twagera mu kibira sisi okunoga ebibala sisi twali tubinoga sisi ne tulengere sajja o mama lyali ddene nnyo ngatenga gwanvu sisi ne litugoba emisinde sisi ne tukaba n'amaziga iyo mwesirikira abaana sijja kubalya nja kulya balya bakulu abagenda n'emugga.
Nice, you sound a great singer, you see?
I can sing.
Yeah, I really like that song. And yeah, remember we did it again with a kind of new twist with mm-hmm. Onyango mm-hmm. and Noah. So we did with Onyango, so we did a twist of it and oh. recorded it. And it's already on my YouTube channel.
So guys, go to the YouTube channel.
It is Adrian Matov Art. So that's my YouTube channel.
And of course, you are going to see this same video on his YouTube channel.
Yeah,
don't forget to subscribe if you're on Edwin Matovu.
Yeah,
and
follow.
Guys, too, I would like to say thank you for always following up our YouTube channel. And don't forget to subscribe and like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's one thing I can say. Can I have opportunity to say it?
Of course.
Yeah.
This is our channel. Let's say.
Yeah, the other thing, like, guys, I'm making my album. It will be done very very soon, but I'll be releasing one song per month so that I can create some space for me to bring something which is really sounds good.
So yes, which, and that brings me to the question, so now give these people exactly where do they find you on Spotify.
So my Spotify, you can just put Adrian Matovu. Adrian is with E-D-R-I-N-E, then Matovu is M-A-T O-V-U. So Spotify, that's why I put Adrian Matovu.
Mm-hmm.
You can just put the name of the song. So far there's one song, but next week I'll be releasing another song. The first song is Free Will. I think we're going to play it at the end of this video. They will listen to
it. At the end of the video, I'm going to play a song. And also I'm going to put the links of the YouTube channel of Adrian Matovu and at the same time the Spotify of Adrian Matovu.
Yeah,
I'm going to put them down.
Nice. And also Facebook page. I have a Facebook page for my artistic work only, also called Adrian Matovu Arts. So that is there. Adrian and Matovu. Instagram, it is Adrian Matovu.
Sure.
So Facebook,
I'm putting all this that you can follow Adrian Matovu on Facebook, Instagram, Spotify, and YouTube. And don't forget to always subscribe and like comment, so that you can get the
and
new
even
songs
to ring
coming.
That bell.
Ding, ding. And so I hope that there's a new song because every month
I will be dropping one
a new song.
One good
dropping
a song. One
dropping
song.
A song.
Every month.
Super.
Yeah.
But also, guys, I shall have Edwin Matovu again to mainly talk about how mainly the world of education, how we did it to do the masters here. And for those who are there back home and you know you are thinking of doing your masters in music and dance and here in Europe and using the same education system, you don't forget to subscribe to Edwin Matovu at and subscribing to Otako at the same time. All the links are down.